Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Cherno. More Cherno. Is that my name? More Cherno. What a silly name. Welcome back to another reaction, my thoughts kind of video. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Battlefield 2042, Battlefield 6. This trailer came out around like 18 hours ago, I think. I still haven't taken a look at it. This is my life now. I don't look at stuff until I record myself looking at stuff. What a life. But anyway, I'm super excited to take a look at this little bit of background. I haven't really played a Battlefield game since Battlefield 3, but Battlefield 3 I loved a lot. Bad Company 2 I played as well. Well, not talking about like Battlefield 2, because Battlefield 2, Battlefield Vietnam, Battlefield 2142 even, I definitely played a lot of those. Battlefield 2, I remember playing a lot of that with like the Project Reality mod. Man, that was like my high school life. That was honestly like, for a little bit there, that was my high school. I remember around the time that Battlefield 3 came out, so did like Modern Warfare 3, and Modern Warfare 3 was just not anywhere as good as like Modern Warfare 2. So I think that Battlefield 3 kind of took me for a ride there. Before we get into this gameplay trailer, which will be linked in the description below, by the way, if you haven't watched it, I do want to announce that tomorrow Ratchet & Clank is coming out. I have secured myself a PlayStation 5 and I have ordered a copy of Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart from Amazon. So if we can trust Amazon to actually deliver it tomorrow, which is launch date, then I will be live streaming myself playing it on twitch.tv/thecherno. I'll have a link in the description below. Definitely tune in for that. It'll probably be around like 6 to 7 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. I don't know what time that is in your time zone, but I've put up a schedule on my Twitch channel, so check that out and you should be able to see what time it is locally. I'm super excited to play it because it's probably gonna be my first real like PlayStation 5 game. Up until now, I've played like It Takes Two with my wife, and that's Last of Us. I'm actually going through like Last of Us Part 1 as well, like the first one. So like, yeah, not really PlayStation 5 games just yet, but Ratchet & Clank tomorrow, really excited for it. But now let's dive in and take a look at Battlefield 2042. By the way, I used to work at EA for like 4.5 years on like the engine team. Oh my gosh, why are you showing me that quality? So this is a little bit dear to my heart. Why is it lagging? It's already, my computer can't even handle the video. Oh, I've always loved their snowy environments. Flawless so far. Oh wow, I love that fire. Ah, oh, that explosion is perfect. Ooh. Damn. Ah, oh, I always love those DICE logos. Like the way that they animate them and stuff.
Push, push.
I love the Jets. Oh man, that's like that classic move video from that video. Oh, I love that. Kind of miss working at EA. Okay, so like, where do I even begin with this? I mean, like, first of all, it looks phenomenal. Like, it looks amazing. Like, it looks as good as any game I've seen. You know, Battlefield has always been really good at that kind of photorealistic rendering. In fact, Frostbite in general has been really good at that, I think. You know, there were some, like, the art is just phenomenal, and I think that, you know, having those art assets, having those talented teams behind the actual assets are really what make this shine. I mean, you know what I mean? Like, a game engine is not going to make an explosion look good. It's not necessarily going to do that. But having an actual, like, explosion, like, I don't know what this is. I don't know if this is, like, some kind of video, you know, that's actually, like, you know, a real explosion, because that's it could be. You know, I mean, obviously some of the clouds here, the smoke clouds do seem to have some lighting, but my point is just that, like, you know, the work that has gone into creating these environments, like, even like all this snow over here, like all this in the background, like, it's just amazing. I think, like, I honestly, it's just amazing. And I think that is kind of, that goes the furthest out of anything else here. Like, you know, in terms of new tech, I mean, you know, Battlefield 5 had like some ray tracing as well. So it's not even like going to be that kind of revolutionary, I think. I mean, on consoles, obviously, it is going to be pretty cool to be able to see some of this new stuff. This part over here, I noticed as being ray traced. Like, you can see the reflections in the puddles. It's reflecting that explosion. That's really cool. By the way, I'm saying ray traced. This could be a screen space reflection. Like, I don't know. You know, some of this stuff, I think, did definitely look like it was ray traced. I don't really care. You know, the scene looks good. I'm sure it does use ray tracing in some forms. One thing I really have noticed, though, about this trailer is there is so much, like, film grain. Like, look at that. Like, there's so much kind of noise there, and it's hard to tell why that is. I think it's just a stylistic choice, to be honest. I think it looks really cool with that noise there. Yeah, like Frostbite, and it's not even like Frostbite, but I guess EA and their studios have just always been so good at like particle effects. Like, this really does remind me, like, it even going back to like Battlefield 3, I mean, and like Bad Company 2, just like everything shattering, you know, all of the kind of sparks, they've always just looked so good. Some of these kind of like wide shots, and just like, again, the amount of debris they've got, the amount of detail they've got in these shots, like, it honestly just looks like a movie. Like, look at all this. Like, it's just so well done, you know? I don't have any other words. It's just so well done. This was really cool as well. This kind of neon light environment. We haven't really seen much of that. And I guess 2042, you know, it's set in the not so distant future. Unlike, I guess, Battlefield 2142. So, you know, kind of being able to be a little bit more relatable, but also a little bit futuristic. I think it's a really cool setting, actually. Yeah, again, all of the effects, like just the visual effects are just amazing, you know? And notice how, like, I mean, there we go. There's a nice kind of reflection of something that's clearly off screen. So that would have to be basically be ray traced, most likely, unless it's like reflection probes. Anyway, we're not going to get into like rendering stuff today. I don't really care about that. I just, these effects are just amazing. And with like the depth of field as well, we recently looked at like at Horizon Forbidden West, and like, you know, there were some issues with like the depth of field. Like, you can see that they're just not here. Like, this is just like, it's just perfectly rendered. Like, you know, they're kind of out of focus elements here, and you can see kind of it doesn't have any of that. So that's kind of what I was talking about, I guess, in that video. I absolutely love the jet kind of gameplay as well. I think that's super cool. And then, yeah, like this move of just getting out for a second and firing your rocket launcher, that's really cool. I'm glad they included that shot because it reminds me of like the actual gameplay, I guess. And Battlefield was, again, a game that I loved, but I just kind of fell out of it. And to be honest, like, I think I might be getting back into it because this is insane. And that was also a reminder of the multiplayer component, which I'm assuming it's going to be really heavy on. I mean, I think I read something like an article earlier this morning, or just I saw the headline. That's really it. But that, like, it's not even going to have a campaign or something. I'm not sure if that's 100% confirmed. But yeah, like, obviously Battlefield has always been a multiplayer game, and like, yeah, that kind of jet move just reminded me, I guess, of the kind of fun you can have with like this huge kind of open world, like multiplayer situation where it's just like this huge kind of battlefield. So yeah, I mean, honestly, like, I can't say much else than like I'm very impressed. I think it looks amazing. I think this is a really good example of like a team that like knows what they're doing, you know, and creating amazing assets for this game specifically. Like, I think the assets and the art and just the quality of everything here, like the animations, the cinematics, like, I'm really excited to see some actual gameplay footage, by the way, because obviously this was all just like cinematics, even though it was in engine. Yeah, 128 players, like, that's really cool. 64 players on the PlayStation 4. Yeah, that's right. It's also supporting older kind of generation consoles, not just the next gen stuff. Man, I kind of almost wish I was still working at EA so I could get my hands on an early copy. That was actually something they used to do when I worked there. We basically got like 10 free games per year, so we could get like 10 of any EA game. Basically, you fill out like this little games order thing, and they just like give you like up to 10 games a year. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. Please don't forget to hit the like button. Let me know what you want me to take a look at next. Don't forget tomorrow, Ratchet and Clank live stream. Hope to see you guys there. Link will be in the description along with the schedule. I will see you guys next time. Goodbye. Yeah. Yeah.